What's up, friends? It's Mike again. Glad to have you guys back for another review. So when I go traveling, I always carry around my Peak Design 5-liter bag. It's small, it's light, and it's very easy to access my GoPro and my RX100 Mark V. Now, as a video maker, it would be nice to get a gimbal to get those buttery smooth shots. Well, actually, I have one in my bag. It fits in with everything else that I have. So this, my friend, is a ZHIYUN Crane M2. Its axes are all locked up, so it's really easy to carry. It doesn't like flange around everywhere, and it's really easy to set up as well. All you gotta do is clip the quick release plate inside like so, and then lock it, release its locks, turn on your camera, then power it on. And it's ready to go. So this gimbal can hold your action camera, your smartphone, and your compact camera no problem at all. It can do a lot of things, and it's very versatile. It has a battery that can last you 7 hours, and you can charge it while using it through its USB Type-C port. And all of that is cool, but most importantly, it can get you this kind of footage. Roll the clip. So welcome back. I hope you like what you saw just now. That was my friend helping me shoot those B-rolls. He's a professional gimbal user, so thanks for your help, Kinshin. And first of all, full disclosure, ZHIYUN did send me this gimbal free of charge for me to review, but I don't get paid to say anything good or bad about them, so everything that's said in this video is my opinion only. So today, we're gonna go over the performance and the different modes to see if this is the right gimbal for you. So to start being a vlogging gimbal for your vlogging setup, selfie mode is quite important. You can access and do that through 3 taps on the back to switch it back and forth. So in selfie mode, I do like to use the Go mode because it reacts the best to my arm so that I can see what I'm seeing. And with Go mode, it's more like action camera mode, so you can switch to people really fast. This is my friend Jack who's helping me film and back to me. So it's pretty good. And while we're in selfie mode, it's good to test out the audio because you want to notice and hear if there is any motor sounds, because if that gets in your footage, it just kind of ruins the whole film. And if you have it balanced right, you should not hear any sounds. For me, I don't really hear it when I review my footage, so that's always a good sign. And while we're at this, you might want to notice how it's stabilizing my footsteps as I'm walking. And I'm going to do some runs like this over here. And you can see how that is stabilized. And then I'm gonna do a shot that I'm running without the gimbal so you can see the difference and the difference that it makes using one. Okay, so to do that test, I'm gonna take it off. It's very easy. You just pull the quick release plate out. So right now I'm walking and talking with my camera, and you wanna see how it is when it's compared to the gimbal or using it on a gimbal. And I'm gonna start running right now. So how much more stabilized is it with the gimbal? Let me know in the comments below. Okay, so while in selfie mode, you can also go portrait mode for all you Instagram stories or Snapchat kind of people. You can talk like this and it is stabilized, and yeah, it's pretty good. But I don't do that kind of stuff. So all I have to do to put this back into normal mode is triple tap on the back, and there we have it. We're ready to do some B-rolls. Okay, so you can switch to different modes pressing the M button. With the trigger, whenever you hold it, it turns into follow mode. And when you let go, it goes back into the mode it's in. In this case, it's pan follow. So in this mode, it's really nice that the vertical axis is locked. So you can go really low and get those low angle walking foot shots and go run like this very easily. It's also kind of like flashlight mode, and bring it back up whenever you want. You don't have to like twist it in a certain way. It just works. And in this mode, it turns when your hand turns. So this is really good for those jib shots and really get those high angle to low and yeah, those cinematic shots. The other mode is the lock mode, where it locks the camera into place so that you get the same angle no matter where you go. And in this mode, instead of bringing a slider, you can just slide your camera and you'll get one of those really cinematic shots as well. And as we go into POV mode, this is like a 360 degree synchronized kind of mode. It kind of goes in like slow motion and follows your hand everywhere. This is really good to get those immersive shots, and you can actually control it because it's kind of slow. It's kind of like the opposite of go mode. But anyways, because of the speed, you can really create those creative and immersive shots with it. So with lock, pan follow, and POV, they all switch by pressing the M button once. And if you want to go into go or vortex mode, you have to press it twice. And of course, in go mode, it reacts to how your wrists react very quickly. It's also called sports mode. So when you're capturing footage of kids, children, pets, dogs, and really fast action-paced stuff like sports, this is what that mode is for. And next, if we double press it again, it goes into vortex mode. This is also called the inception mode. People say it's a gimmick, but I don't think so, because I actually use this quite a lot. This actually adds like a lot of depth into your footage. And when people see it, they're like, what? What the heck? How did they get that kind of shot? So it's quite impressive that they added it into something this size. And by the way, this can hold a lot of weight, like up to 720 grams. So I'm never worried when my compact camera's on it like this. It's quite secure. So after all those modes, if you want to take it down, you just turn your camera off, turn your gimbal off, lock it into place, and then release this axis, push it up. And the special thing about this is that they have a pin over here that pops up to lock the part over here so that it doesn't move when you press it down. And then you gotta lock it again, and well, bam, it is fixed and ready to be put in your pocket or your bag. Taking my camera out, I am ready to pack up and go home, guys. Just kidding, there's one more part. And the other thing I forgot to mention is that you can actually control your camera using the analog controls over here. So on the side it has a zoom slider, and then on the front it has the record button, and that's pretty much all it can control, which is all you need, right? So this might look like the best gimbal out there because of all these features and functions, but the question is, or is it? Well, after using it for 2 weeks, I did notice that if you want to use different devices on this, you do have to rebalance it each time. And if you use the action cameras or your phone, it's actually pretty hard to balance it because it's so light. It will take some time, but once you do it once, you're good to go for the next time. The other thing is that if you want to use motion time lapse or active tracking mode, you always have to go into your phone. And because of that, it's kind of annoying because you do have to take out your phone and wait for it to connect to your gimbal by Bluetooth. And that time does take a bit of setting up to do. And it's just too bad you can't control the motion time lapse through your gimbal, or else that would have been really cool. So if you're mainly using your phone, it's not that big of a deal, but if you're using a compact camera or your action camera, I don't think you'll be using motion time lapse mode that much. And the third thing is that this gimbal costs $270. It is quite an upgrade to your footage, but if you only use a smartphone on your gimbal, there are cheaper ones out there that does what a gimbal does, which is smooth out your footage at a cheaper price. But if you're mainly using your compact camera on this gimbal, or potentially all three devices, this is the one that you should go for. I personally think this is the best vlogging compact camera gimbal out there right now, because I love taking my RX100 with me. I actually use it more than my A7 III for B-rolls and just having it in my pocket to vlog with. So for the longest time, I've always wanted to improve my filming game with my compact camera, and the Crane M2 was definitely the solution for me. So there you have it, guys. I really hope I helped you out in this review. Consider the good and the bad, and really to help you see if this is the right one for you. If you have any questions, please comment below. I'd love to help you guys out. Thank you, ZHIYUN, for sending this out to me for a review. Again, I really enjoyed using it. And if this video has helped you in any way at all, remember to like, subscribe, and turn that notification bell on to get the latest updates about my channel from YouTube. And that's it, guys. I'll see you in the next review. Bye. So guys, I just noticed I've been saying ZHIYUN wrong the whole time. How do you say it?
ZHIYUN.
ZHIYUN. Is that right?
Almost. You're okay. Almost there.
Say it one more time.
ZHIYUN.
That's how it's done.